Good morning students. Today we are going to see the topic as subroutines. So normally we studied what is function. So what is function? Function is an action. We going to do that action. That is function. That is function. In the function declaration, we just define action. In function implementation, what action we are going to do, that action we are implemented. That is in function implementation. This all are studied in 11th standard. What is function? What is function declaration? What is function implementation? Everything we studied here. Subroutine. Here what section we going to study? But the small changes is there. Function is a set of action. That is more number of action we are going to define. Here subroutine in the sense, it is similar to a function, but small action only going to do. That's all. So moreover, subroutine and functions are same. That is segments of code. Functions also segments of code. Subroutines also segments of codes. Here, subroutine are the basic building blocks of computer program. Subroutines are small sections of code that can be used to perform a particular task that can be used repeatedly. So we going to use repeatedly. That is again and again we are using in a same coding. That time what function we going to call? The name alone different, subroutine. So already we studied functions. So repeatedly we call in a same coding. We just using the name as function. In 11th standard, here the name alone changed as subroutine. That's all. In programming language, these subroutines are called as functions. Programming language, the small segments of code called as functions. Next, functions. So function is a unit of code that define within a greater code structures. So already I explained, if you are giving in a more number of code structure, that is small segment of code, that section is called as subroutine. If you are giving us a more number of code, that is greater code structure, that time we define the name as functions. So functions contains a set of code that can work on many kind of inputs like variants, expressions and produce a concentrate output. Whatever the function, function is a action. When you are implementing in some action, that time what we need input, based on that input we need as a output. Based on that input, we will be getting as a output. How can we get that output? So that time we need as a some variants, expressions and expressions. What is variants? Variants is nothing but variables we need. Expression in the sense, if you are giving in some conditions, that's all. Based on that condition, you will be getting in a output. That's all. That is functions. Good morning students. Next one is function specification. So we already know how to specify the function. How can we specify the function? Data type, function, function name, bracket, you just give that arguments you want to give. That like only we have to declare. So function name within a bracket you want to declare in a some arguments. Here you see the example as, let us consider the example a colon equal to bracket 24 they are giving. So here a colon equal to bracket 24. So normally how can we declare a variable a equal to 24? Here additionally we are giving the colon alone, additionally they are giving. So this is not your variable declaration. Here they are passing as a arguments. This 24 is your arguments. This is a function definite specification. What are the value we given in that bracket? That is called as function specification. That is not in a normal variable declaration. Here, so a is a variable. In that variable we are just passing the argument here, not passing the value. So 24 is not a value, it is an argument. Why it is not a value? because it is will be given in the bracket. So whatever may be, you just given in the bracket, that is considered as an argument. That is called as function definition. Next one is so parameters. Already we know what are the value we given in that bracket, that is called as parameter. In the parameter we have in a two type, one is parameter without type and another one is parameter with type. So without type means we no need to give any data type. So parameter, arguments, everything is same. What are the value you are passing in that bracket, that is called as arguments or parameter. Here you see, this is your function definition, power of a bracket b minus 1. Here b minus 1 is your parameter here, that is parameter or argument or anything. Here you see any declaration is there, whether the b is belongs to any integer data type or character data type or float data type, nothing. A and B are not blanks to any data type. Where, whenever you are giving a value, based on that value, the compiler will be allocate, this is blanks to integer data type, this is blanks to float data type. For example, in a compile time, A equal to 5, B equal to 4.5. So what are the data type the compiler will allocate? A equal to 5. So in the sense, 5 is an integer data type. So the compiler take the value as a equal to 5. It is blanks to, so a blanks to integer data type. B equal to 4.5. Just I am giving an example. So that time 4.5 is a float data type. So that time compiler will allocate, so b blanks to float data type. In the first initialization period, a and b blanks to no data type. Whenever you compile, that time when you compile or execute time, you just given the value, based on that value the compiler will be allocate the data type to a and b variable, that is parameter without type. The parameter, it belongs to any data type. What value you are giving in the runtime, that is execute time, the time only the compiler will allocate the data type to the parameters. That's all. Next one is parameter with the type. So parameter with the type means you must give the data type, that is compulsory match. For example, here a int, b int. So what data type a and b belongs to? It must belongs to the integer data type. So a and b are both are integer data type. When you are initialization, that time we are declared a is a integer, so you must handled only integer values. B is an integer, so it is also must handled integer data types. That's all. That like whenever initialize, that time we declared, that is that time we define it, a and b are integer data type. That's all. That is the difference between with data type and without data type. In a with data type, a is an integer data type, b is an integer data type, we are allocated. Without data type, a and b are does not belongs to any data type. That's all. That is the difference between with the data type and without data type. Good morning students. Today we are going to see interface versus implementation. What is interface? First of all, we have to see what is interface. Interface is a set of action that can object can do. So normally interface means that is a intermediate between any two persons or any two objects. Here in object oriented programming language, interface is a set of action. Object oriented programming language, who will give the set of action? A function will give the set of action. So the function defines the set of action. What action you going to do, that is defined by function. Here interface is a set of action that can object can do. For example, if you are switch on the light, what will happen? The light will be switch on. Next, so in a programming language, you just describe all the functions in order to in according to that class will be do. Here, how can they define that? Type T
whatever the interfaces is, you just give it any interface, that is any action you going to give. Next one is a class declaration combine the external interfaces which are implementations of the interfaces. A class declaration, you already know that how can you declare a class, what is class, what is object, everything we studied in a 11th standard. So if you don't know, you just clarify the 11th, you just take the book in 11th standard book, you just clarify your doubts. A class declaration. So interface defines an object visibility to outside the world. So object visibility, what are the object visibility we studied? Private, public, product. These all are object visibilities we studied in a previous classes. So here interface defines an object visibility to outside the world. Next, implementation. What is the difference between interface and implementation? We see in a next class.
Thank you.